Hello, my name's Simon Crafer, and today we're in the Alpine Stars truck to discuss for the Tech Talk rider safety equipment. Let's start with leather suits in the beginning. Early leather suits I had were road ones, you know, which were obviously on a road bike, you're a little more sitting up position, and also you need to walk around a lot, so they've got to be comfortable standing up, walking around. But when you get down into, which is almost a fetal position, and then try to move your arms out to the bars, those road suits just don't fit. They're all baggy and loose in the front. They're restrictive in the back area and stop your arms all stretching and moving out. And if you're fighting against the leather suit, uses a lot of energy, you end up tired, but also, you know, restricted movement, but also arm pump, no good. So the race suits are much more designed for that fetal position I was telling you about, you know, the race position. If you look, the arms are already bent, for example. The suits are much shorter in the front. They're not even comfortable to wander around in. For me, I've got to unzip them just to walk off to the toilets. But on the bike, they are fantastic. And let's explain why. Like, for example, let's start at the bottom. We'll run through the protective stuff at the same time. Like all the front of the shins here, all up into the knee, full of protection, you know. We'll get back to sliders later, but the first of that paneling, that which is called accordion paneling, it stretches. So the reason for this is you need the suit to fit snug. So when you have a fall, the protection doesn't move around. I had it in the early days, moves out of the way and you wear down to the bone. So if it fits snug, perfect. It stays that protection in the right place, but the way they can get away with it not cutting off circulation is this paneling. And let's move on up here. They've got protection around the coccyx area, hip area, lots of that accordion paneling in the back so the rider can lean right forward without being restricted. Now let's move up. Look, more of it here under the arms so it can stretch. He can move his shoulder forward. Awesome protection in the shoulders, obviously. Then more of that paneling so the arm can move here. Working down here, we've got awesome protection all along underneath the forearm, like really quite strong. And this is a first difference that have been pointed out to me, is for example, Marc Márquez, the amount he uses his elbow and touches on the ground, but they've even got some aluminium insert in there to make it more durable for the amount of time he's putting it down. Big area for when he really tries to hold the bike up, like we've seen him do. Carl Crutchlow, who's obviously super fast, but doesn't use the elbow on the ground at least as much or at all. So the it's more traditionally focused for protection for a crash and a little bit better aerodynamic because it's a bit smaller. Let's move around to the back. These humps also vary, like from the different riders, because of different size riders, their helmets, and to help with aerodynamics, you know, the different shape riders. So one other thing I should point out that I've seen is if we moved back there, we've got Cal Crutchlow, then we've got Nakagami's. He's got, you know, the tank supports, like the tank grab things to help the rider hold onto the tank with his leg. Well, they've got it inside the leg there as well. It's this grippy silicon panel, which is fantastic. I'd actually like to try that. Then we've got Alex Márquez. So I would say, looking at it, Mark and Carl would be the opposite extremes with the elbows, and these guys, Nakagami and Alex Márquez, are somewhere in the middle. So that's leather suits and a bit of fitting. Let's move along to boots. And they're another thing that's moved a long way since I rode, well, beginning of my career anyway. So these are the standard road boots you can buy, and they're pretty much identical. So the one, this is Alex Márquez, he used it in Jerez. I'll point out the changes. The thing is, Alex Márquez used this in Jerez. And riders love things that are a bit worn in because they feel comfortable. And instead of giving them new ones, they've cleaned them up, put a new sole on. And why they put a new sole on, like, in my experience, the sole is probably the fastest wearing thing in racing because the foot pegs are very aggressive, like real sharp ends on them, and they eat away on those boots because the riders are putting so much pressure on them. And the riders actually have a choice of a softer sole, that's a bit more grippy, less durable, or a harder sole, a bit more durable. And then we'll move along to toe sliders. You can see that's like the original one. Some of the riders, like Aleix, a couple of others, use the stock toe sliders here, protection for the boots. Others, like Alex and quite a few others, use none because they don't touch the road with their toes. You've got to think about, these aren't street bikes with low, wide foot pegs. They're state-of-the-art race bikes that keep your feet off the ground and in close, and so you don't wear them out. Look, the other thing is the protection of these boots. Now, when I first got to Europe and first got the World Championship, my boots were that protective, really easy to hurt your ankles in a crash. And the thing is also, before we move on, I've got to show you inside. The other thing I love about this is heat protection in the sole and all up around the inside. Because if you think about those glowing engines, they're so hot, and especially in a hot country when you're riding, so much heat goes in, but also through the aluminium footbed into the sole of your feet. I ended up in Japan and Malaysia with big blisters on the sole of my feet and on the inside of my ankle. So that's a great development. Speaking about protection, like I said, that's what my boots were like, but also heels. Look at this inner boot, how protective it is. It moves freely, but restricts how much the ankle can twist. Fantastic hinge system there. But I mentioned heels because in a high side crash, you get launched up in the air, and I've had it a few times where I've flipped up in the air, over, landed on my back, and my legs went slap on the road, which means your heels get whacked. And it's one of the most painful injuries I've ever had. Throbbing ankles for literally really bad for a few weeks, and then lingers on for months. It's like bruised bone. And now look at this. It's like a helmet for your heel. It's a nice protection and all good, really high technology foam on the inside. And that slips inside what I used to wear, much less protective. Look at that, straight in there. It's all the rider has to do is slip his foot in, pull that tight, lock it in, zipper up, and jobs are good and beautiful. Let's move along now to the gloves. We've got a pair of Mavericks gloves here, Vignales. I think I'll start with the amazing protection for like palm of your hand hitting the road, for really good protection, strong. Then the other thing riders do, obviously knuckles, big protection on there, but they're also aerodynamic and vented, so the air goes in here and out here, a bit of ventilation there. But protection wise, how many racers have really damaged their pinky finger, gets caught under the bike, gets broken. Look at this, I really like this. Lots of protection, but also strapped to the next finger so it can't bend around there. And they're the fingers that you hold on with, those ones, constantly wrapped around the bar holding on. It's the other two, as we move along, quite a bit different job. Riders either use one or two fingers, and those ones the glove needs to fit beautifully, like protective on the front, fit beautifully. These are brand new, they haven't been worn before, and they're molded so perfectly to like human form of fingers because they need to be protective on the front, but they need to feel the brake pressure perfectly, but also releasing the brake in that danger area where they break right near the apex, front could fold. They need to feel exactly how much pressure. That's why it's thin and, beautifully formed, ready to go. I'd say the only other thing I should point out about the gloves is this protection here. That's the one Maverick prefers. They're quite solid, strong. Then we look at Dovi's gloves. They're identical until you get to here. It's more of a soft, that really trick foam I was talking about, because Dovi is a little bit more sensitive to restrictive things and arm pump. He wants that so he doesn't feel the glove there. I think the next thing we can move along to is knee sliders, which we didn't speak about on the leather suit. Thing is, knee sliders, I'd say the first thing is the compound. I think these companies have developed a lot. In my day, the development was early, and too hard makes a lot of noise when it touches the ground. It's almost off-putting, but also there's no friction, so your knees like sliding around the road. Too soft, they obviously wear too quickly, no noise, but they grip the road and pull your knee around, you know, leg out. And so they've developed over a long time to be the right balance of that, you know. Then I would say position, before we move on to how do the riders use them. The position, as you're slower or riding in the rain, it's a little bit more to the front because you've got to poke your knee out a long way. And then as you get going faster and you lean over more, it's more you're trying to get your knee out of the way, close to the bike, and it's more wraps around the side. So it's more here. So the leather suit has a big range you can move that around on. And then the next thing I'd say is how much the riders use them. It varies a lot, you know. You have guys, in my day there was a lot of riders that used them extreme, had new ones every session. Someone I was told uses them a lot recently would be Jorge Lorenzo on the Ducati. A wild guess was maybe he didn't trust the front as much or whatever it is. And I think riders, it's between trusting the front and their style, use them a different amount. Some force them into the road on every corner. Others, like I did, or apparently Quartararo does now, is just kisses that feel, you know, feels the road. It's more like a gauge, but it's there. If the front goes, they can go, oh, and try and hold the front up. So they vary from having one of these every session, all the way through till guys getting days out of them, you know. So big extreme there. Here's another one I want to show you. It's actually designed for the rain, more, you know, being you don't lean over as much, so it's a bigger form. But also, the guys like it's Saxon Ring, and the guys that use them really hard. You know, if you imagine Saxon Rings, all lots of left-hand corners, lots of time on the side. That's getting ground away. They're using it a lot. Some riders that use them hard go for this one. It's Saxon Ring on the left side to last the race. You know, so that's knee sliders. Next thing I got quickly show you before we get on to back protector is chest protector. In my day, it was optional. It's obligatory now. I like them because unless you put on a bit of weight and you can't get them in there, they are comfortable. They're made out of this really same high technology foam. Gets softer as it gets warmer from your body, but it takes a good impact and absorbs it. It's amazing stuff. Anyway, that slips into the suit. You don't feel it. I like it also because you don't get that vibration through the tank as much when you're lying down on the bike and feel a bit safer, obviously. Next step would be to show you what is inside the airbag suit, which has the back protector on it. So I'll tell you what, no, I'll show you the outside first. Come over here, it'll make more sense. This is what's available on the market and has been for a while. I've got this one, same one. And this is, they can have different firmware in it for the racetrack or the road. And the reason I say that is because they're quite different applications, meaning they're different types of accidents. So they need to be, you know, tuned for those different ones. So someone needs their leathers. Then this is the new one here, and it's available on the for the road now, but meaning road firmware, but coming soon for the racetrack as well. And most of the riders now use this. It's more ventilated, it's lighter, it's a bit more flexible, and this, where the electronics are, is built into the hump. And the teams like it because it bulges less and the leather's a bit more aerodynamic. Otherwise, very similar. Let's have a chat about what's in this. Now, this goes on in the rider, in the suit, sorry. Let's come and have a look here. This is the actual airbag. What would you call this, Chris?
Chamber,
that's it, the chamber. So, for example, here's the gas canisters here. and we'll talk about the firmware. When the firmware decides that, can you believe, in 25 milliseconds, it can decide to inflate. That's how long it takes to inflate, you know. 25 milli, like to give you an idea, 200 milliseconds for a blink. So awesome fast. And that fills that bag, which is the back area, the shoulder area, and down rib cage area. So basically your whole upper body. And let's finish up by showing you Mark Marquez's crash recorded with the electronics on these suits. At Jerez, his famous crash that he broke his arm. Damn shame we haven't got him here now. But here it is. Look, this is normal. Here he goes. He's riding along. Then, woof, this is where he gets launched. So it feels that. Then it decides he's flying. Bang. It inflates 25 milliseconds. Bang. Inflates just before the impact, which is 25 Gs. Bang. That's the initial hitting the ground. Then he's tumbling. Then, bang, another 25 Gs when the bike hits him. So they've got sensors on both sides of the suit, left and right, and they've got a position, a gyro sensor, so it senses the position of the rider. But if you look back here, look, so he goes bang, 25 Gs, bang again, then he's tumbling, poor fella, bang, roll. The whole crash is about 5.3 seconds. And I've got to say, thank you to the Alpine Stars guys for showing me all this stuff, and I hope you've enjoyed the tech talk. We'll see you in Austria for the next one.